Hi, Richard, sir. Good morning. Welcome to the show. How are you, sir?
Hi. Very good morning, Dinesh. I'm fine, and thank you very much for inviting me to your show today.
Thank you, sir, for your time. Sir, what's the outlook for Nifty and Bank Nifty?
See, overall, the outlook on the markets is positive. After about 2.5 months of time-wise correction or a consolidation phase, the market seem to have resumed the uptrend. The recent up moves has also been supported by long formations in both Nifty as well as Bank Nifty. So we are expecting the market to slowly and gradually move now towards its all-time high. So any intraday declines that we are getting should be used as a good buying opportunities.
So what do you think about Bank Nifty?
I think Bank Nifty would lead this next leg of up move. If you look at last week's data, the derivatives data, on Monday and Friday, on these two trading sessions, Bank Nifty has rallied. Good amount of long positions were seen. And this has led to a high top, high bottom structure in the banking index now. So 20 days exponential moving average around 33,600, 33,550 range is now a good support for the banking index as well. And till we are trading above this support level, the biasness continue to remain positive, and we would advise to look for buying opportunities in the banking space. Now, if you look at some of the private sector banks, then I think they are looking more attractive. Even PSUs are attractive, but since private sector banks have heavyweights in the index, so I think look at Axis Bank, Kotak Bank, ICICI Bank, all the stocks are looking quite attractive on the chart. So we are upbeat on the banking index. We expect the index to surpass this 35,500, 36,000 mark in short term. So any intraday decline should be used as a good buying opportunity.
Okay, sir. Sir, any sector that is looking good apart from banking?
So we have already discussed about the banking space. Apart from that, if you see the mid-cap space is looking quite attractive. Although it's not a sectoral index, but look at the mid-cap space, the higher top, higher bottom structure is getting continued over there. And now with this leg of up move, the mid-cap and the small-cap basket are witnessing good volume. The stocks from this basket are witnessing good volumes along with the price up move. I think mid-cap would be one basket which one should focus on. Then PSU banks are also looking good post the SBI results. We have seen good buying interest in SBI, and I think the other stocks should also show a good follow-up move now. So these are some of the spaces that were traders, short-term traders, to watch out for.
So the fear of NPA has gone out, at least.
Yeah. So I think that's a good sign, and that would lead to some buying interest in most of the PSU banks now.
Okay. So any stock idea that you would like to share with our viewers?
From the banking space, Axis Bank, I would recommend to go long on. Recently we have seen that the stock has given a breakout from a trendline resistance, and it has now again resumed its high top, high bottom structure. 720, 725 is the support range. So if we get intraday dips around the 725, one should use that opportunity to create fresh long, keep a stop loss below 710, and one can expect short-term targets around 760.
Thank you, sir. Thank you so much for your time.
Welcome. Most welcome. Yeah.